You right there watching this video, I love you. I love you and I appreciate you. And I hope that you are having a really, really, really good day. Anyway, YouTube team, keep it clean. What's going on? It's Engraven here with another video. And the Ravens, they were very, very busy yesterday. And I mean, the whole NFL world was very, very busy. But if you weren't paying attention, there was some stuff that kind of slipped through the cracks. Now, while we were all hyped over the schedule coming out, and more specifically with the Ravens schedule coming out, we found out early in the morning that they were going to be playing the Raiders. They were going to start off their season on Monday Night Football. Prime time. The world is watching the very last game of the week. And I know there were some people that like, oh man, I'm not going to feel like waiting. I'm not going to feel like waiting through Thursday, then Friday, then Saturday, then Sunday, and all Monday. And I told them like, hey, it's May right now. You got 4 more months to wait before football starts anyway. So I think you'll be just fine. But anyway, we were all hyped thinking about the different games that we might go to. And when we saw the tickets for them Raiders games, we were like, and the different games we might not go to. But it was exciting. It's a very exciting time. And like we said yesterday, this is the last sort of injection of excitement that the NFL puts in the fans. Because this is the last thing. We've gotten through the first and biggest wave of free agency. We've gotten through the draft. And we've gotten through the schedule release. So now we wait. But anyway, yesterday the Ravens were very busy. And even today too. But yesterday, if you weren't paying attention, like I said, it might have slipped through the cracks. Now, while we were all thinking about the schedule, the Ravens, they were busy signing their draft picks. And the first draft pick that they signed was Mr. Rashad Bateman. Wide receiver from Minnesota. Of course, y'all know his story already. But he signed his rookie deal. And the thing that I love about the rookie wage scale is that it makes life so much simpler for everybody. It makes life simpler for everybody that's involved. You know exactly how much money you're going to get paid by exactly where you were drafted in whatever round. It's already set. There are no discrepancies. There shouldn't be any arguments. It's straightforward. You already know. Except if you're a Bosa brother. You know the Bosa brothers. Those dudes, they divas over there. They like holding out and, oh, no, I want this. No, I want that. No, you got drafted where you got drafted. Just keep it moving. But anyway, Rashad Bateman signed his rookie deal. And with him being a first-round draft pick, it is a 4-year deal with the 5th-year option. So that means once it comes in that third year, then the Ravens can choose whether they decide, well, after the third year, the Ravens can choose whether they decide to pick up his 5th-year option or not. And with teams picking up the 5th-year option for different players or not picking up the 5th-year option for different players, it's not all black and white. Just because a team does pick up the 5th-year option, it doesn't mean that the player is going to stay. Just because a team doesn't pick up the 5th-year option, it doesn't mean that player is going to leave. Because what they could do, they could pick up the 5th-year option and not even re-sign the player after that. Or what they could do is not pick up the 5th-year option and sign the player to an extension early. So it all just depends on how the team wants to operate with the player. So Rashad Bateman, he signed his rookie deal. Odafe Oweh, the Ravens' other first-round draft pick, he has not signed his rookie deal yet. So it's coming. But I would expect everybody to be signed by Saturday, maybe Sunday. This is not going to be some long, drawn-out thing. They're going to sign those deals, and they're going to sign them pretty fast. Because the Ravens, I mean, he wasn't the only one that ended up signing his deal. They also got Sean Wade, the cornerback, the slot cornerback. They signed him to a deal. They got Ben Mason, the tight end slash fullback slash tight end slash fullback slash tight end. They signed him to a deal. So he's locked up. And also Dalen Hayes. The outside linebacker. So they moving through the class. And they don't have some huge, enormous, big rookie draft class that they need to sign. But they're moving. So again, this shouldn't take long. It shouldn't be a long process. Though I don't expect any holdouts. I don't expect any of that. And with them, it's very important for these guys to sign their deals so they can really like fully participate in whatever it is. Because you don't like if you don't sign your deal and you trying to play for the team, and you go out there and you practicing or something, you get hurt. Oop, oh, they didn't sign a deal. And I don't think Ravens would do anything like grimy, anything like that. Be like, oh, you know what? You got hurt and you didn't even sign your deal, so we're not going to pay. No, they wouldn't do anything like that. They definitely wouldn't. They are not a classless organization. But these guys, they want to get under contract before they do anything physical whatsoever. But the Ravens, their draft picks weren't the only guys that they were signing. Today, it was announced about 15 minutes ago, because I'm recording this at 11:22. Exactly 15 minutes ago, that the Ravens signed 9 undrafted rookie free agents. And this is something to pay attention to, because the Ravens usually every year, they have an undrafted rookie free agent on their roster. Now, probably the most impactful one over the past couple of years, I would say, was Patrick McCurry. Patrick McCurry, somebody, undrafted rookie free agent. I believe he went to Texas. I'm not 100% sure on that. But came in, Matt Scora went down in that Monday Night Football game against the Rams, and it was looking very scary. But Patrick McCurry came in, and he picked up where Matt Scora left off, and he did a phenomenal job. Now, last year, it was a bit of a struggle, but it was a bit of a struggle for the entire offensive line, not just Patrick McCurry. But shout out to him, because he came in, again, undrafted rookie free agent guy. So rounds 1-7 came and went. He didn't get picked up, but he didn't let that stop him, and neither did the Ravens, and they did their thing. So the Ravens, they signed 9 undrafted rookie free agents, and let's just go through the list. They signed safety Ardarius Washington from TCU. Now, this is a guy that I'm going to be watching some film on very soon, because I have heard a lot of good things about Ardarius Washington. I've heard a lot of people talk about Ardarius Washington. Shout out to the light going out. But people love this guy. They love this guy. And they say that he is a baller, and were very surprised that the Ravens were able to get this guy as an undrafted rookie free agent. Somebody else, a quarterback, Kenji Bahar, offensive tackle, Adrian Ealy, tight end, Tony Paulsen, one of my guys in the comment section, literally every single video, he said, Graven, we need to talk about Tony Paulsen. We need to talk about him, because he is a baby Gronk. He's a baby Gronk. And I'm like, okay, we're going to see. I haven't got a chance to look at him yet, but when I do, trust me, you will know. And then defensive tackle Xavier Kelly, running back Nate McCrary, offensive tackle Foster Sorrell, wide receiver Dante, his last name I cannot pronounce. I'm going to try it. Dante Cilenco. Now, it's funny, because one of my guys asked a question from subscriber about him months ago. He asked a question from subscriber on should the Ravens pick him up at wide receiver. Because he talked about how him and Lamar Jackson, they went to the same high school together, so they got that connection. And you know Lamar, he's one of them people that remembers his people, even from way back. So shout out to Dez from Pompano too. But they went to Boynton Beach High together, and the Ravens picked him up. So he already got a little insider. Again, Benjamin Victor, he from Pompano, I believe. I told you, man, some people get mad when I say Florida Ravens. Like, somebody commented on a video the other day. They were like, what are you guys talking about when you say Florida Ravens? Ravens been a thing way before anything had to do with Florida, man. And I'm like, the reason I say that is because literally everybody on the team is from Florida. Everybody. So, and I love it. I love it. But anyway, so we'll see what happens with that. And they also got outside linebacker Barrington Wade. So the Ravens have been making some moves. They've been doing some homework, and they've been doing some research, and they picked up some guys that they feel could contribute this offseason and give them a chance to try to make the roster. So we'll see how it all works itself out. And we will be going over these guys individually, looking at some different film on some of them, especially guys like Ardarius Washington and Tony Paulsen as well, and maybe even Dante Cilenco. That last name, I'm so sorry. But anyway, team, keep it clean. Ravens been busy. We've been busy on this too. But I love y'all. I appreciate y'all. And just like the schedule is now officially, because again, that leak schedule was kind of on point, but it had a little tiny things missing here and there. But anyway, just like the official schedule is, we out.